नमस्कार, राज जुडिशियल में आपका स्वागत है। कल हमने 300 क्वेश्चंस तक किए थे, आज हम 300 के आगे करेंगे। आप वीडियो को पॉज करके उसका आंसर एक जगह लिख लीजिए और मेरे साथ चेक करिए। चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं। 301, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज अ जजमेंट इन परसोनम? आंसर बी। 302, द प्रिजम्पशन अंडर सेक्शन 41 ऑफ द इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट इज? आंसर सी। 303, विच फाइनल जजमेंट ऑर्डर और डिक्री ऑफ अ कॉम्पिटेंट कोर्ट अमंग द फॉलोइंग इज अ जजमेंट इन रेम? आंसर सी। 304, एविडेंस एक्ट जजमेंट ऑफ अ सिविल कोर्ट इज बाइंडिंग ऑन द क्रिमिनल कोर्ट अंडर ऑल सर्कमस्टांसेस? आंसर बी। 305, एन एक्सपर्ट अंडर एविडेंस एक्ट इज अ पर्सन? चार ऑप्शन, आंसर इज सी। 306, द ओपिनियन ऑफ एक्सपर्ट इज नॉट रेलेवेंट? आंसर इज ए। 307, वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट अबाउट एक्सपर्ट ओपिनियन? आंसर इज सी। 308, द रिपोर्ट ऑफ अ मेडिकल ऑफिसर स्टेटिंग द इंजुरीज ऑफ द विक्टिम इज? आंसर बी। 309, ओपिनियन ऑफ एन एक्सपर्ट अंडर सेक्शन 45 ऑफ एविडेंस एक्ट? आंसर सी। 310, अ डिस्प्यूटेड हैंडराइटिंग कैन बी प्रूव्ड? आंसर इज डी। 311, मार्क द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, अ कोर्ट मे टेक द असिस्टेंट ऑफ एक्सपर्ट फॉर फॉर्मिंग ओपिनियन ऑन पॉइंट ऑफ? आंसर डी। 312, व्हेन द कोर्ट हैज टू फॉर्म एन ओपिनियन एज टू द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सिग्नेचर ऑफ ने पर्सन, द ओपिनियन ऑफ द सर्टिफाइंग अथॉरिटी which has issued the electronic signature certificate is? Answer is B. 313, where the handwriting of a teacher is in question, the opinion of his principal may be relevant under which section of the Indian Evidence Act? Answer is A. 314, which one of the following sections of the Indian Evidence Act, sorry, Indian Penal Code 1860, is expressly excluded by the proviso to section 50 of the Indian Evidence Act 1872? फिर से पढ़ देता हूँ। Which one of the following sections of the Indian Penal Code 1860 is expressly excluded by the proviso to section 50 of the Indian Evidence Act 1872? Answer ए नहीं, डी होगा, सेक्शन 497। 315, अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट विच वन अमंग द फॉलोइंग इज इररिलेवेंट? आंसर सी। 3, एविडेंस इज एबडक्टेड बाय द पार्टीज टू द सूट अबाउट द कैरेक्टर as per the provisions of the Indian Evidence Act, which of the following is correct? These are three options given. Answer is D. 317, in respect of digital signature, which of the following is irrelevant fact? Answer is C. 318, इन क्रिमिनल केसेस द फैक्ट दैट द पर्सन अक्यूज्ड इज ऑफ गुड कैरेक्टर. आंसर इज बी. 319. कैरेक्टर ऑफ अ पर्सन फॉर पर्पजेज ऑफ द लॉ ऑफ एविडेंस इज नॉट रेलिवेंट इन वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सिचुएशन. आंसर डी. 320. इन क्रिमिनल प्रोसीडिंग्स अंडर विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सिचुएशन द फैक्ट दैट द अक्यूज्ड पर्सन हैज बैड कैरेक्टर इज रेलिवेंट. आंसर डी. 321. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट करेक्ट. नॉट करेक्ट. आंसर सी. 322. द टर्म कैरेक्टर एज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन सेक्शन 55 ऑफ द इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट 1872 मीन्स. आंसर बी. 323. Mark the incorrect statement. Incorrect statement, not correct. Incorrect. 323. Answer D. 324. The court shall take judicial notice of. Answer is D. 325. A judicial admission operates as. Answer is D. 326. Court can take judicial notice. Answer is D. Consider the following statements. The proceeding of the Parliament or State Legislature of India are judicially noticeable facts. Rule of the road on land or at sea are not judicially noticeable facts. Criminal law in force in India is judicially noticeable fact. Which statement is our correct? Answer is D. 328. Which of the following facts needed to be not proved? Need not to be proved. Answer C. 329. Facts judicially noticeable. Answer B. 330. The facts of which the court must take judicial notice include the. Answer is D. 331. The term judicial notice under the Indian Evidence Act 1872 means. Answer is D. 332. Facts which need not be proved by the parties include. Answer is A. 333. A witness who is made unable to speak gives his evidence by writing in open court. Evidence so given shall be deemed to be. Answer is A. 334. Which of the following is the best evidence? Answer is B. Direct evidence. 335. Which one among the following statements, according to the Indian Evidence Act, is correct? Answer is C. 336. Under the law of evidence, the term hearsay is used with reference to what? Answer is D. 337. Which of the following is not a hearsay evidence? Answer is A. 338. Exceptions to the rule against admissibility of hearsay evidence are provided. Answer is D. 339. The details of an incident printed in newspaper are categorized as. आंसर इज सी। 340, हियरसे एविडेंस इज जनरली इनएडमिसिबल, हाउएवर इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग केसेस इट इज एडमिसिबल। आंसर इज डी। 341, कंटेंट्स ऑफ अ डॉक्यूमेंट कैन बी प्रूव्ड बाय। आंसर इज ए। 342, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज प्राइमरी एविडेंस। आंसर इज बी। 343, विच वन अमॉन्ग द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट करेक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट। आंसर इज सी। 344, when a number of documents are made by one uniform process as in the case of printing, lithography or photography, each is? Answer is B. 345, a document can be proved. Answer is A. 346, a carbon copy of the injury report prepared by a doctor by one uniform process by which the original was prepared may be admitted as? Answer is B. 347, photocopies of a document made from the original are? Answer is B. 348, where a bill of exchange is drawn in a set of 5, how many of them need to be proved? Answer is C. 349, secondary evidence includes? Answer is B. 350, an item of evidence which is not a secondary evidence is? Answer is D. 351, secondary evidence is admissible. Answer is B. 352, secondary evidence of a document means? Answer is C. 353, oral account of the contents of a document by a person who has seen it is? Answer C. 354, secondary evidence of the contents of a document is not admissible when? Answer D. 355, in which of the following secondary evidence relating to a document cannot be given? These are the four options and answer B. 356, for providing, proving execution of a registered will, it is necessary to? Answer is B. 357, under Indian Evidence Act, a document required by law to be attested can be proved by calling. Answer is B. 358, if no attesting witness can be found, it must be proved that. Answer is C. 359, when the court obtains a sample of handwriting, Indian Evidence Act 1872, the court, answer is B, itself may compare the same or may refer to an expert under section 45. 360, which of the following is not a public document with the meaning of Evidence Act? Answer is D. 361, which one of the following is not a public document? Answer is A. 362, public document includes? Answer is D. रिकॉर्ड ऑफ ट्रिब्यूनल, रिकॉर्ड ऑफ कोर्ट, रिकॉर्ड ऑफ पब्लिक ऑफिसर्स. 363, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ पब्लिक डॉक्यूमेंट? आंसर इज बी. 364, विच इज नॉट अ पब्लिक डॉक्यूमेंट? आंसर इज डी. 365, विच इज नॉट अ पब्लिक डॉक्यूमेंट? आंसर इज डी. 366, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ पब्लिक डॉक्यूमेंट? आंसर इज बी. 367, वॉट इज अ प्राइवेट डॉक्यूमेंट? आंसर इज डी, डॉक्यूमेंट अदर देन अ पब्लिक डॉक्यूमेंट. 368, पब्लिक डॉक्यूमेंट अंडर द इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट कैन बी प्रूव्ड बाय? आंसर इज सी. 369, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज करेक्ट? पॉज द वीडियो एंड राइट द आंसर. आंसर ए. 370, ड्यू एग्जीक्यूशन एंड ऑथेंटिकेशन ऑफ अ पावर ऑफ अटॉर्नी शैल बी प्रिज्यूम्ड अंडर सेक्शन 85 ऑफ द एविडेंस एक्ट व्हेन एग्जीक्यूटेड बिफोर एंड ऑथेंटिकेटेड बाय? आंसर इज बी. 371, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मे प्रिज्यूम? आंसर इज सी. 372, period of 30 years under section 90 of evidence act is to be reckoned from? Answer is C. 373, execution of payment may be presumed if the document is to be old? Answer is C. 374, section 90 of the Indian Evidence Act applies to? Answer is C. 375, the presumption under section 90 of the Evidence Act can be drawn in respect of? Answer is A. 376, in cases where a document proved to be 30 years old is produced from proper custody, which of the following presumption will the court make? Answer is C. The court may presume that the signature and handwriting is the signature and handwriting of the person to be and was duly executed and attested. 377, how many years old electronic record will be deemed to be proved if it is produced from any custody which the court in the particular case considers proper? Answer is A. 378, under Indian Evidence Act 1872, reports published in newspapers are? Answer is D. No evidence at all. 379, section 91 of the Indian Evidence Act applies to? Answer is C. 380, which one of observation is correct? Answer is B. 381, assertion A gives B a receipt for money paid by B. Oral evidence is offered for the payment. The evidence is admissible. Reason, a receipt is not a contract or grant in respect of which oral evidence is barred. Answer is A. Both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. 382, point out this incorrect statement. Read the options. Answer is D. 383, section 92 of the Evidence Act is applicable to disputes between? Answer is A. 384, section 92 of the Evidence Act applies to? Answer is A. 385, mistake referred to in provision 1 to section 92 the Indian Evidence Act refers to? आंसर इज सी. 386. When the language used in a document is on its fact, ambiguous or defective of facts, which would show its meaning or supply its defects? Answer is D. 387. Latent ambiguity in a document means ambiguity. Answer is C. 388. In criminal proceedings, the burden of proof is? Answer is A. 389. Burden of proof under Section 101 of the Indian Evidence Act, 1872. Answer is B. 390. Consider the following statements. In criminal proceedings, the burden of proof is? On the prosecution to prove the guilt of the accused person, on the accused to prove his innocence. Which of the statement is R correct? Answer is A. 391. A desires a court to give judgment that B shall be punished of a crime which A says that B has committed. According to the Indian Evidence Act, the burden of proof is on. Answer is A. 392. In election petition, in burden of proof lies on. Answer B. 393. The principle of proving beyond reasonable doubt applies to. Answer is A. 394. In criminal trials, the onus is on the accused to prove that his case falls in. Answer is D. 395. To prove the case of alibi, the burden lies on. Answer is D. The accused. 396. Section 105 of the Evidence Act requires that the court - presume the absence of such circumstances which brings a case within the purview of general exception in the Indian Penal Code. The answer is B. 397. Any person in Section 106 of the Indian Evidence Act refers to. Answer is C. Sorry, answer is A. Party to the suit. 398. A person is presumed to be alive if it is shown that he was alive within. 398. Answer is D. 30. 399. Section 108 of the Evidence Act proves that when a man has not been heard for 7 years by those who would have heard of him if he had seen alive, the burden of proving that he is alive shifts on the person who affirms it. Answer is A. Naturally. 400. The man who has disappeared and remained unheard of for 7 years by those who would have naturally heard of him if he was alive. The presumption then arises that he is dead. What shall be the presumption as to time of death of such person? These are the option. Kindly read it properly. Answer is C. 401. Section 111. 111 of the Evidence Act speaks of such situation where one person stands in a position of - to the other person. Answer is C. 402. According to the Indian Evidence Act, which one of the following statement is not correct? Read the statements properly. And here you have to answer which is not correct. Answer is D. 403. इन केस अ चाइल्ड इज बॉर्न विद इन 280 डेज ऑफ डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ मैरिज द मदर रिमेनिंग अनमैरिड द प्रिजम्पशन ऑफ लेजिटिमेसी ऑफ अ चाइल्ड अंडर सेक्शन 112 ऑफ द एविडेंस एक्ट ए राइजेस. आंसर इज सी. Unless non-access is proved, the presumption as to legitimacy of any child born during the continuance of a valid marriage between his mother and any man is. Answer is D. 405. Presumption under section 112 of the Evidence Act is raised. Answer is C. 406. Assertion. Even for a child immediately after marriage, presumption of legitimacy under section 112 of the Evidence Act would apply. Reason. The legislature, which extended the period of operation of the presumption by 280 days after resolution of the marriage, did not choose to exclude any minimum initial period of matrimony for application of the presumption. Answer. A. 407. In case of suicide by married women, the court under section 113A of the Evidence Act may presume that suicide has been abetted by her husband if suicide was committed by the wife within a period of 7 years from the date of her marriage, the wife was subjected to cruelty, the wife was illiterate and from a poor family, the wife was deserted by the husband. Answer is D. 408. Statement A. The presumption under section 113A of the Evidence Act is not attracted if the marriage took place more than 7 years prior to the suicide of women, even if cruelty is established by prosecution. Statement B. By the introduction of section 113A of the Evidence Act, the prosecution is not required to prove the facts beyond reasonable doubt against the accused. Which of the statement is correct? Answer is A. 409. Which one of the following is not the prerequisite of presumption as to dowry death under section 113B of the Indian Evidence Act? Answer is B. 410. Which is not a precondition to raise obligatory presumption under section 113B of the Evidence Act? Answer is A. 411. In which of the following cases the court may presume under section 114? Answer is D. 412. Section 114 illustration G of the Indian Evidence Act 1872 refers to the presumption as to. Answer is B. 413. Rules as to burden of proof are. Answer is A. Rebuttable presumption of law. 414. Burden of proof is lightened by. Answer is D. 415. Which of one of the following under Indian Evidence Act 1872 is not a kind of estoppel? Answer is A. 416. Estoppel can be by. Answer is D. 417. A person cannot deny a statement previously made. Answer is A. 418. Which of the following does not figure in section 115 while dealing with applying the principle of estoppel? Answer is A. 419. Which of the following statement is incorrect in the context of estoppel as dealt in section 115 of Indian Evidence Act 1872? Answer is A. देर मस्ट बी अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन बाई अ पर्सन टू अनदर. 4-0, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट? आंसर इज सी. 4-1, स्टॉपल इज? आंसर इज ए. 4-2, स्टॉपल need not be specifically pleaded, should be specifically pleaded, may be specifically pleaded or may not be specifically pleaded. D, both B and C. Answer is B. 4-23, mark the correct statement. Answer is A. The doctrine of estoppel is applied only in civil matters. 4-24, who may not testify? Answer is D. 4-25, who amongst the following is not a competent witness? Answer is B, an idiot person. 4-26, all persons are competent to testify unless the court considers that they are prevented from understanding the question put to them because of. Answer is A. 4-27, which one of the following is not a competent witness to testify under the Indian Evidence Act 1872? Answer is D. 4-28, a witness who is unable to speak is called as? Answer is B. 4-29, who amongst the following are competent witnesses? Answer is D. 4-30, who among the following is competent to adduce evidence under Indian Evidence Act? Answer is C. Both 1 and 2, dumb witness and deaf witness. 4-31, dumb witness may give his evidence by writing or sign in open court. Such evidence shall be deemed to be B, oral evidence. 4-32, which of the following statement is incorrect regarding dumb witness? Incorrect. Answer C. 4-33, what is the evidentiary value of evidence given by husband against wife and vice versa under the Indian Evidence Act 1872? Answer is D. Evidence can be adduced by both in civil and criminal proceedings. 4-34, a husband or wife are permitted to disclose any communication between them during marriage. Answer is D. 4-35, in criminal proceedings against any person, the husband or wife of such person shall be. Answer is A, competent witness. 4-36, assertion B writes to his wife C a letter which contains defamatory matters about D. C cannot be compelled to disclose this communication. Reason, any communication made during subsistence of marriage by a husband to his wife or vice versa is protected as a privileged communication. What is the right answer? Answer is A. 4-37, Section 121 of the Indian Evidence Act provides for the privilege in respect of which of the following? 4-37, answer is B, judges and magistrates. 4-38, privilege under Section 121 of Evidence Act is A. 4-39, under the Indian Evidence Act 1872, which among the following does not come under the category of privileged communication? Answer is B. 4-40, which one of the following is not privileged communication? Answer is B. 4-41, which one among the following is common in the provision of Section 123, Section 126 and Section 127 of the Indian Evidence Act? Answer is C. They are relevant and inadmissible. 4-42, a communication made to the spouse during marriage under Section 122 of the Evidence Act आंसर इज ए। फोर फोर्टी थ्री, डॉक्यूमेंट्स इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ विच प्रिविलेज हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड अंडर सेक्शन 123 ऑफ द इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट। आंसर इज बी। 444. Which one of the following statement is correct? The protection of professional communication as provided under Indian Evidence Act 1872 in section 126 to 129 is available to. Only answer is D. After commission of the crime or illegal acts. 445. Professional communication between advocate and his client. Answer is C. 446. When a party refuses to produce a document which he has notice to produce, can be used the document as evidence afterwards? Answer is B. 447. If asked to a witness to any matter relevant to the matter in issue and the answer given by witness to such question will criminate him then? Answer is A. 448. An accomplice is a person. Answer is A. Who participates in the commission of crime with regard charged accused. 449. Select the right option. Assertion: the evidence of an accomplice requires to be accepted with a great degree of caution and scrutiny. Reason: he hopes for pardon or has secured it and so favors the prosecution. 449. Answer is B. 450. Which of the following statement is correct with respect to an accomplice? Answer is B. An accomplice shall be a competent witness against an accused person. Thanks for watching. We'll end up here. All the best for your examinations. We'll meet in the next video. Thank you.